What is our fourth main topic today?
This comes to us from Kyle Arking. Hi, John and crew. Hello. It has been announced that the sensational Florence Pugh has been cast as Princess Irulan in Dune Part 2. I screamed in the middle of Target when I heard this news. Princess, am I pronouncing that right? Irulan?
Yeah. Irulan?
Princess Irulan plays a major role in the second half and in the sequel, so I'm really excited. I can't wait to hear who will play the Emperor. My pick is Christian Bale. Thanks and have a great day.
All right, thanks a lot for sending that in. And yeah, listen, for those who know Dune and the Dune story, as fantastic as the movie is, one of the things that will jump out to you right away is, where's the princess? They didn't have the princess there. Now, if you go back to the sci-fi miniseries of Dune, they introduced the princess very early on in their iteration of, because she does play such a major role. If you know the Dune story, in the overall narrative and where the movie ends up, where the story ends up, she's incredibly pivotal and important in all of it. So where is she? And it left people like me wondering, because I remember after I first saw Dune, I think I brought it up on the show, it's like, I wonder if maybe they took some creative liberty and they're just going to not have the character in there. They're going to come up with something else. That didn't make a lot of sense because they're following pretty closely in a lot of other ways. But still, no princess. Well, we've got our princess now. She's here, and she is one of the hottest stars in the world right now in Florence Pugh. This comes to us from the folks over at Slash Film, who write the following. Arguably the most in-demand young actor around, Florence Pugh has entered talks to join Dune 2. And this won't just be some throwaway role either. The actor is apparently being courted to portray Princess Irulan, a character who is an enormous influence in the author Frank Herbert's original Dune novels and who stands to play an integral role in the films to come. Should this casting pan out and fans of both Pugh herself and the actual IP should certainly be hoping that it does, it would represent the first major casting addition to the sequel, with Pugh joining the A-list ranks of those who'll be reprising their roles for another go-round in the battle for control over the desert world of Arrakis and, well, the Empire at large, because damn it, the spice must flow. And I'll tell you what, this is phenomenal. I mean, look, Denis Villeneuve is, I might go out on a limb right now and say he might be the biggest director right now that actors want to work with. Like, everybody will want to be in a Christopher Nolan film. Everybody will want to be in a Steven Spielberg film. Everyone may want to be in an Antoine Fuqua film. Everybody may want to be in whatever, or an Ava DuVernay film, whoever.
Or Scorsese.
Or Scorsese, another one. But I think right now, the one that everybody wants to work with is Denis. And so when you look at the already absolutely stacked cast of Dune, would it be a surprise if one of the most in-demand actresses right now in Florence Pugh would also be lining up to be on that list? I'm not surprised at all. And you know what? I think, now that I think about it, I think the on-screen chemistry between her and Timothée Chalamet would be awesome. But it does raise a great question about, well, then who's the damn emperor? Who do they, because we didn't see him either. And again, in that miniseries, he arrived fairly early.
And that's her father, so it can't be Christian Bale.
Yeah, no. So
Christian Bale can't be Florence Pugh's father.
Or why not?
Maybe he could, I guess.
Yeah, why he could. He totally could.
You got to get somebody. You got to get an older actor to play the emperor.
I guess
if Sally Field could be Daniel Day-Lewis's wife in Lincoln, there's, I mean, anybody can be anything.
Oh, let me do this. Hey Google, how old is Christian Bale? So we find the same
thing. Christian Bale is 48 years old.
So Christian Bale's 40. He could easily be her dad. Stop. Now Google one shot.
Shut up.
So he could totally be it. Again, I don't do the X actor and X role sort of things. Just make sure you get a really great actor and I'm totally fine. Christian Bale certainly falls under that category. And we're about to see him in Thor Love and Thunder as Gore the God Butcher. So they maybe have him pop up in this too. But that will be interesting to see. Listen, by the time they get to the point where they're negotiating the contract, that already means the studio's decided she's the one they want. She's decided she wants to be in it. 95% of the time once they enter this stage, it gets complete. So I'm just going to assume at this point she's going to be in it. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. I always say just make sure who you're getting is talented. They got one of the hottest, most talented up-and-comers right now. You can't even call her an up-and-comer name.
No.
She's here. She's arrived. It's done. So I love this casting. I think it's great. Rob, you are our resident masters in duology. not a lot of people know that at the University of Calgary, Duneology is an actual master's degree program there.
Yeah, professor. In Calgary, the first thing you think about when you walk outside is sand dunes.
Yes, yes, exactly what you think of when you're in Calgary.
No.
But you're a big Dune guy.
What do you think of this? Look, I think this is great casting. And Princess Irulan, like you said, in David Lynch's Dune, she actually opens the movie.
Right.
You know, she's Virginia Madsen floating in space. The beginning is a very delicate time. Know then that it is the year 10,191. Yes, it's true. And I think it's great. And I love it. I love Florence Pugh. I think she's great in anything. I mean, and she's got just some amazing range. And I really think that she can play like a street level urchin, and she can play royalty. And I think she's one of our most exciting young actresses. And this role where she has to be regal and she's called upon. I mean, if they go on and make further Dune movies, like I always thought they were going to make three Dune films. They were going to do Children of Dune, which would be a big deal for her, or and Dune Messiah. So I think it's great. I love this casting.
Rob, how dare you not mention Dunefall?
Dunefall.
You know it's interesting you say
Revenge
that
of the butthole
because that's kind of what happens if they're going to do Dune. If they're going to do Dune Messiah, Children of Dune, there's a lot of Dune that's going to fall. There's a lot of people who die, billions, in fact.
Aaron, I know that you're a fan of Florence Pugh. You like her work. You hear about this. What do you think? Is she a good match for Dune?
Oh, I think that she, as Rob said, she really has shown that she can run the gamut and is not of types of movies that she can be a part of and roles that she can play, whether it's a period piece, like when she did, what was the movie, Little Women? And then, you know, she is in the upcoming Oppenheimer, which, as we've talked about on the show, has an incredible star-studded cast. She's in Don't Worry, Darling, which is also an incredible star-studded cast. I mean, she has so many different types of projects under her belt that you really can't pigeonhole her and put her in one specific spot as an actor, which is great. I mean, it's brilliant work on her part. It's brilliant work on her team's part. I also think that given the fact that she has been in a relationship with another famous actor for many years and seems to be able to keep her private life just that and her relationship status.
Well, now I got to ask, who?
She's been dating Zach Braff since 2019.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
He normally likes the Filipino girls, but okay.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, no. I'm thinking of Zac Efron. I'm sorry. I was totally thinking about Zac Efron. Totally different guy. No, Zach Braff, as far as I know, has not had a thing for Filipino girls. Sorry. Just stop that rumor right now before it goes too
run
far.
Anyway, the two,
run it.
Yes, the two of them have been in a relationship for a while. But yet the thing that we all and a lot of times what we see is someone's relationship status with another celebrity, you know, will eclipse that. But they've managed to really keep their private life private and let the focus be on her work, which I think is really astounding, especially for a young actress. Like, let's all remember, she's what, 26 years old? She is not, you know, she's not in her 40s. This is a young actress. And a lot of times with that degree of fame in a celebrity relationship, in movie after movie after movie, it's so easy for young actors and actresses to, find that their career takes a back seat to the celebrity. And Florence Pugh seems to be someone who has made all the right decisions, whether it's in the team that she has surrounded herself with, the projects that she is choosing to work on, or simply just, you know, her attitude. You know, it really, really speaks volumes to the kind of professional that she wants to be. And clearly other people are noticing that because they keep... Okay, and now we're talking about her.
Yeah.
I shouldn't even have brought it up.
You shouldn't have brought it up.
That's a my bad. Sorry,
people, for people who are wondering, Florence Pugh is 26. Zach Braff is 46.
Go Zach.
What's he famous for? What role is he
did
famous?
Scrubs. And he also,
which was awesome.
But he also directed Garden State.
Yeah, when he did a very, very good job.
Which I really love that movie.
Yeah, and it was fantastic.
And he got really drunk with me once. Like, I didn't get drunk, but I was standing there with him.
Is he good drunk? Mean drunk?
He was very funny.
Hilarious.
Yeah, he's one of these guys who, once he starts getting toxic, he just gets funny. I mean, so that was.
We actually have common friends, so I've run into the two of them together several times. And they could not be more lovely, and she could not be more kind and humble and just lovely, lovely people.
Well, it's good to see. But anyway, back to Dune.
Back to
Princess Irulan.
My God.
Bring it on.
That sounds good to me. Question is for you guys. What do you think about? I think this is fabulous. Just adding more talent to this, getting Florence Pugh in there, incredible. Who do you think could maybe play her father in this thing? Who knows? Whatever you guys are thinking, jump down to the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. Hey guys, we want to take a minute and thank the sponsor of today's video, the good folks at Keeps. Now look, you guys probably already know that 2 out of every 3 men will experience some form of hair loss by the time they're just 35 years old. Now that's where Keeps comes in, because Keeps has more 5-star reviews than any of its competitors. That means the guys that use it love it. Keeps offers a simple, affordable, and stress-free way to keep your hair. It's also low cost. Treatments start as low as just $10 per month, and Keeps offers generic versions for the 2 FDA-approved medications to prevent hair loss. That means treatment plans are affordable, typically half the cost of pharmacy prices. Keeps has everything your hair needs delivered straight to your door with discreet packaging and proven results. Remember, prevention is the key. Treatments can take 4 to 6 months to see results, so the sooner you act, the better. When it comes to your hair, save more, spend less with Keeps. So if you're ready to take action and prevent hair loss, go to Keeps, that's KEEPS.com/Campia to receive your first month of treatment for free. That's Keeps, KEEPS.com/Campia to get your first month free. Keeps.com/Campia.